Comic Boom.
Hey guys, Comic Boom here to review Justice League issue 34. Look, I'm reviewing this because I've reviewed virtually most issues of the Justice League, and because in this issue, finally, it would appear that Perpetua wins. Doom wins, or at least would appear to win. I struggled prior to me doing this video in terms of how I would produce this video, what things I would say, because overall, I feel a little bit, maybe not a little bit, maybe even a lot disappointed. I've been on board Scott Snyder's run. I mean, I've been sort of excited. The Doom Justice War, my favorite aspects of this entire Justice League run is I like the nostalgia of introducing the Monitor again, bringing the Monitor, the Anti-Monitor, the World Forger in, sort of incorporating and putting a new spin on the history of the DC Universe from a crisis level event point of view in introducing these new types of just sort of the new mythology of the crisis, all these crises of the DC Universe. I like the Monitor, the Anti-Monitor, the World Forger, the idea of Perpetua, and at least on the surface, the idea of the breakdown of the source wall that is the barrier between our universe and all the other 51 worlds of the total 52 worlds, Earths of the multiverse. I like that. It's very epic. We got the symbol of the Hall of Justice, and we have the opposite of that. We got the symbol of Doom appearing in various issues of DC Comics across the board as Doom wins. Ultimately, at the end of this issue, Perpetua finally rises, embracing that seventh power, and Doom takes control, and we're right now in the heart of DC's Year of the Villain. Now, essentially what happens here is that Kendra, the reason why I got Kendra here in the Monitor is that Kendra here really screws up. It's basically just like Batman caused all that crap and Metal going on in Metal. Kendra here, she allows her anger to get the best of her. She's still so angry at Lex Luthor for killing Martian Manhunter, where she had an imaginary son with in the sixth dimension. Who is the son being Shane, who still exists somehow, we don't know how. In any event, she's still angry at Lex Luthor, and her job basically, and this is flowing back from the previous issues, I'm not going to do a complete summary of all that, suffice to say that we got some Justice League members in the past who've discovered the Justice Society and are now working with Vandal Savage to try to utilize a piece of the totality to open up a portal into the present to feed power through Kendra's wings into the Ultra Monitor, who is a combination of the Monitor, Anti-Monitor, and World Forger. And by feeding Ultra Monitor all that power, they can defeat Perpetua and defeat the forces of Doom. Meanwhile, the Justice League members in the future, who are Superman, Wonder Woman, Batman, etc., they've got other heroes of the multiverse that were brought to them by through Commandy, like the Justice League Beyond, and various other heroes from the multiverse. They're battling in the future against the Brainiac 1,000,000, and ultimately they appear to be, both the past and the present seem to be, both the past and present Justice Leaguers are generally successful in opening up a portal and defeating who they have to defeat. The one failure here, it would appear, is Kendra, because rather than do her job and use her wings to sort of help channel those energies of the various fragments of the totality from the past and the present, opening a portal into the present, which would filter through Kendra's wings, Kendra unfortunately spends more time focusing on trying to kill Lex Luthor that she ends up being temporarily incapacitated, or at least delayed in some way, and that delays just enough to allow Doom to gain the upper hand. Now, couple of criticisms here about the comic. Well, first I'll give a compliment. I mean, the art here continues to be stellar. Scott Snyder's the writer. Redondo on the art. Howard Porter. I mean, these guys are really good. Artistically, this is a pretty good comic book. Where it seems to fall a little short, and I'm beginning to feel some degree of frustration because I was really hoping that it was going to be over, even though I knew it wasn't. Scott Snyder's been telegraphing for, frankly, over a year now that Doom is going to win, I guess. We knew that for a while. It's just that we're 34 issues in, and it does feel like it's sort of dragged on a little bit. Having said that, Perpetua now has basically won, and now we've got that Doom symbol all over the DC universe. And on every DC comic, of course, we see now all the primary villains of Year of the Villain have taken hold. And so Doom is basically, if you look at all the comic books in the DC universe right now, all of them have the Doom symbol out on the very last page. Whether it's Catwoman or Wonder Woman or the pages of Teen Titans or Deathstroke, I mean, the Doom symbol is everywhere. And that's because all those comic books which came out before Justice League, we now have an explanation as to where the Doom symbol came from. It's because Perpetua has won. Now, straight up, I don't know why I feel so underwhelmed by it all. It just doesn't, I know why I feel underwhelmed by it all. I'm not excited. Why aren't I not excited? It's because DC, and I'm going to say this point blank, and Scott Snyder, you need to hear this, because I hear through the grapevine that you're doing Dark Metal 2, or Metal 2. I think that's a huge mistake, because I don't think anybody wants Metal 2. I don't think anybody wants it. I know I don't want it, and I don't know anyone who does, quite frankly. I want to be straight up about that. We have enough darkness. DC, it's almost as if the editorial at DC is angry and are basically flipping the bird to all us fans who keep saying the same thing over and over and over again, and we're going to keep saying it. We need a little bit more rebirth and a little bit less metal. We need less darkness and some more lightness. Why do you think Flash Forward number 2 was so well received and it's in the top 10? It's because Wally West is back, and even though there's maybe you could argue that there's some deficiencies in the story for Wally West, even the prospect of Wally West being a symbol of hope, everyone's buying it, because that's what we want. Flash Forward number 2 is the best comic book that came out this month. This is just more darkness. We don't need more darkness. We need more darkness like we need a hole in the head. I really want Justice to win, and I'm sure it will. This is leading into January. We still have every 2 issues. Every 2 weeks, we're going to get another issue of Justice League. I am looking forward to how this is going to end, Mr. Snyder. I am. And this is, you're not as bad as Tom King, who's dragging on, who clearly never had a clue how he was going to end Batman. And of course, we got the disastrous Batman 81 to show just how truly awful Tom King is as somebody who wrapping up a larger narrative. He doesn't know what he's doing. You gotta be very careful, Mr. Snyder. You don't want to end up like Tom King on this. I'm still wondering what the seven forces are of creation. What was the seventh force that Perpetua got at the end of this issue? That was never explained. I've read this 3 times already, and I don't know what is the force that Perpetua has obtained at the end. Was it Doom itself? It's not fully explained. It doesn't really make any sense. Has sided with Doom. So I guess enough of the world has sided with Doom. The seventh energy is unlocked. The balance is tipped. That's all that Lex Luthor says. But what is the seventh power? We don't know. Now, bear in mind that we got a terrible explanation in issue 31, I think it was, and what three or four of the other forces of creation are. And from reading from the void wind to the black apple, no idea what those are. Very poor explanations for that. That's why this narrative is falling apart, is that we don't know what these other seven forces really are. And that's why, as someone that really likes to get into the heart of a story, I'm so disappointed with the focus on just ridiculous things. Why are we supposed to care about Kendra never had a relationship with Martian Manhunter that took place in the sixth dimension. It doesn't make sense that Kendra would allow herself to get angry, to abandon her responsibility of saving the multiverse. Kendra, Scott Snyder, even in your own writing, you established Kendra being initially in your early pages of Metal. Kendra was one of the challengers of the unknown, where she was the Guardians of the Mountain. Embraced herself as Hawkgirl. She had more responsibility than this. She was more intelligent than this. Now you've insulted her character by making her do something stupid by lashing out at Lex because the Martian's dead? Also, is Kendra, you've established the fact that the only way that Martian Manhunter could potentially even be resurrected is if Lex Luthor is kept alive, because an aspect of Martian Manhunter is it within Lex Luthor. So why would she even want to attack and risk killing Lex when that's the only way to potentially bring Martian Manhunter back? And she ought to know that if she's got even a functioning brain at all. Again, disappointments here. You're not thinking through, you're not giving the characters enough credit, and you're delving into one-dimensional storytelling here on the very characters that you ought to know should know better. You're also not focusing on what you should be focusing on. I'm sorry to play script doctor here, but I don't care about half the characterizations of these characters here. I want to know what the seven forces are. Why? Who cares? Like, who cares if the seven forces are united? How does bringing them all together do anything dangerous? I need an explanation for this. I don't get it, so it sort of takes me out of the story. I was really hoping that you were going to give us that payoff. You've strongly implied that you were, and you haven't yet. Instead, you're still focusing on a bunch of nonsense going back and forth between past and present, and why? Why? Why not spend 4 or 5 straight issues explaining specifically what each individual force is and how it's related and how they're connected? That's what you need to do. I mean, you've had 34 issues. You haven't done that. And this is, you know, I was really hoping this was going to hit pay dirt sometime. We were going to get some big payoff. Instead, this is really rushed. It's rushed, man. It's rushed. Like, again, I'm still kind of excited to see how this ends. I want justice to win, but it already seems you've already played your hand, unfortunately, Mr. Snyder. And I have a feeling if it's just going to be ridiculous as how this one ended, of how Doom rose, all because Kendra, by the way, where's the Trinity? I mean, can we have Wonder Woman do something useful here? I mean, why are you focusing on Kendra and not Wonder Woman? I don't know. It just seems to me, even this, it's a odd choice here for a Justice League tale, but it is what it is. I just, by focusing on Kendra, you really made her to be a really stupid character. Really, really stupid. She's stupid. And she was more intelligent than this in your earlier issues. Now all of a sudden, she's just somebody, she's like Carter Hall. She's like Rob Liefeld's Carter Hall of the Hawkman of the New 52, nothing but anger. Come on, man. Quit insulting her character like that. She deserves better, seriously. I was disappointed in this issue, kind of all around a little bit. I mean, the art's great, but this really needs to resolve itself. I already want this Doom thing to end. We're getting Doom in every single DC comic as it is. It deals with a lot of nothing's really driving right now. DC overall is on a real creative low point right now. Really creative low point. The only thing that even remotely intrigues me is Flash Forward. That's it. Because it's Wally West and some hope. Where's the hope here? Let me guess. Let me venture a guess that just in issue 39, where everything wraps up, let me venture a guess that it's going to wrap up in about 2 pages. We're going to get a Deus Ex Machina, and we're just going to get somebody who's going to come out of the Lark at the 11th hour. It's probably going to be Martian Manhunter coming out of an almost defeated Lex Luthor. And we're going to get some nonsensical explanation premised upon one of or three or four of the forces that we're unaware of and we've never heard of yet. And a re-explanation as to how all the forces work. And since we don't know how all the forces work right now anyway, we're not going to be able to criticize it at that time because it's just, and therefore it's going to be a Deus Ex Machina. There you go. That's what it is. Disappointing. I hope I'm wrong. I'll admit I'm wrong if it ends spectacularly. But I got to tell you right now, it's just not looking good, guys. But hey, tell me what you think of Justice League number 34. Hit the subscribe button. Follow me on Twitter at Metropolis40. Until next time, Comic Boom, out.